Hi everyone, welcome to Grace and Glam, and today I'm going to talk about the most infectious thing on planet Earth, which is none other than happiness.
Well, it's time to discuss something interesting, something nice and something joyful, and we are talking about happiness on this International Day of Happiness. Well, International Day of Happiness is commended worldwide every year on March the 20th, and it was conceptualized by the United Nations to form and rouse global happiness movement. Well, the first International Day of Happiness was celebrated in the year 2013, and the theme of 2020 this year is happiness for all forever. I know when I talk about happiness at this point of time, at this juncture of life, when everybody is actually going through a tough time, when all of us are battling with corona, I know it's difficult to be happy, but then we can always try to be happy. We can always afford happiness, because happiness is an internal thing. Happiness is an intentional thing. So let's focus on our happiness. So that's the challenge of life, and we should always accept it. Now, coming back to International Day of Happiness, talking about the theme, which is happiness for all forever, well, let's focus on what we have common rather than on our differences, because as we all are facing a global issue together, so let's find positivity in ourselves, and let's find positivity in the situations for our betterment. Since we're talking about happiness and all of us are battling a global issue, so would you also like to know which are the happiest countries as per the UN survey? Well, any guesses? Let me tell you. Finland tops the list, followed by Denmark and Norway. So let me show you the chart. So this is the chart of the countries, and these are the countries which top the chart, and these are the happiest countries. And let me also tell you the factors or the top indices or the happiness indices which decide the happiness of any countryman as per the UN survey. Well, the very first factor is the income. The second thing is the social freedom, then the distrust factor, and then there is the life expectancy and social support and generosity. So these are the happiness indices which decide the happiness quotient of a country. Now let me show you the chart of Asian countries and the position of India and its happiness. Yes, as you can see that India ranks in the bottom when it comes to happiness, because the survey was conducted among 156 countries last year, and this is the result that we have. Yes, India, you can see the ranking of India, that yes, we are not a very happy country, and we are not even as happy as our neighbors. So you can see that even our neighbors like Pakistan and Bangladesh are happier than us. So it is time that we learn from them. So we are not a very happy country, and we definitely fall flat in the global chart, and also in the not even in the list. We don't even top in the list in the Asian chart. So this is very, very unfortunate. Hence, it's proven that India scores very, very poor when it comes to happiness quotient in the global chart. Definitely, we are a country, so we have to improve a lot, and we need to focus on our happiness. We need to know to live life. Okay, it's very, very important. After all, happiness is all we are seeking every now and then, isn't it? So now, let's talk about the current situation. So I know a lot of people are feeling very, very restless. People are impatient. When is this going to end? And definitely they want to get back to their routine life. But then, there are a lot of ways you can be happier. So, let's escape from our busy schedule and our routine life and ponder on the things we have always, wished to do. We have always tried doing these things. However, we have never found or managed time to do so. So there are a lot of things that we can still do. There are a lot of things like, remember when was the last time you took a proper sleep or you rested well? Okay, so take enough sleep, take enough rest, eat well, spend enough time with your kids, with your pets, play with your pets, that definitely makes you happy. Spending quality time with your family or the significant other, having family lunches. So these are things we have missed, isn't it? You know, have more of me time, nurture your hobbies, do yoga and exercises and meditation. When I talk about these things, of course, it sounds like global gyan, but definitely, you know, when now I'm in a position where, you know, I feel, you know, I am as if it's like it feels like an exile or self quarantine or whatever you can say. I could not go home, right? So, you know, I also feel left out. But then now this is the time when I'm trying to give more time to myself, and I feel very, very revived and happy these days, because somehow I feel that, you know, there are a lot of times that I have neglected, and now I can definitely sit back and relax, and I am focusing on all the things which I had not focused for a longer period of time. And definitely happiness is a thing. I realize that it is an internal thing, and it is a state of your mind, and it should not be governed by others. It should not be it cannot be governed by anyone. So obviously, so happiness is a very, very beautiful thing, and definitely it can't be compromised with anything, right? And let's not forget that happy girls are the prettiest girls, happy people are the healthier people, happy men are the more progressive men, and happy workers are the more committed people. So let's not forget this thing. Now let me give you a few tips to instantly make you happy. Well, if you want to be happy instantly, of course there are a couple of things which I try on myself, and these have worked on me. So like, if you want to be happy, do you know which is the happiest color? Well, yellow is considered to be a very, very happy color. So make sure that you wear yellow and you have a yellow color around you. So that definitely fills you with joy and positivity, and definitely makes you happy. And we have seen that in smileys, all the smileys you would see in yellow color, isn't it? Only for this reason. And you can try listening to some good music, some nice tunes, and that will definitely lift your mood. Okay, because I try doing that every day. And I have a couple of mood enhancers for me. Like, I love reading books, so you can try reading good books. Okay, now you can also try having dark chocolate. So that this is something which is an instant mood enhancer for me. You can try coffee. It also, and it works for me. I'm sure it works for most of you. And definitely stay positive. Okay, keep interacting with your friends over phone or online, whatever way you can. And definitely do not forget to add humor in your life. Okay, so make sure that you add humor, you add hope, you add health in your life. And that's how you achieve happiness. Or it's the other way around, whatever. Okay, so that's all for me. I shall see you again, and I will leave you here happily and meet you again. So till then, stay happy and stay positive.